Welcome to SPHS Chandrapura Teachers Channel. Today we are going to discuss about 8th Standard Science Chapter 1 Crop Production and Management. So first chapter we are discussing so long crop production and management. In the previous class we have discussed about adding manure and fertilizers. And what are the advantages of fertilizers? What are the disadvantages of fertilizers? And what is the difference between fertilizers and manure? All those things we have discussed in the previous class. Today we are going to discuss about irrigation. So before that, I would like to tell you something. Study like there is no tomorrow. Children, listen carefully. Study like there is no tomorrow. If you keep putting your studies for tomorrow, you will probably be too late. So don't be late, children. So every day learn all those concepts or chapter, whatever teachers are giving for you as a whole. With that, we'll start today's session, irrigation. Okay, so irrigation first. Irrigation means what? Supply of water to the crops at regular intervals. Irrigation is nothing but supply of water to the crops at regular intervals is nothing but irrigation. So today we are going to discuss about irrigation and what are the sources of irrigation and methods of irrigation. Okay, so first one is all living beings need water to live. Water is important for proper growth and development. So all living beings on the earth requires water. So why it is required water? For what purpose it is necessary? So water is very, very important for the proper growth as well as development. What? For proper growth and proper development, water is necessary. Okay, and water is absorbed by the plant roots. So how this water is absorbed? So water is absorbed by the plant roots. So plant roots, what it will do? What is the function of roots? The plant's roots will absorb water, minerals, nutrients and fertilizers, whatever we are giving, spraying to the particular crop field. So whatever fertilizers, manure, all those things will absorb by the plant's roots. When the plant's absorbing water, not only water, along with water, nutrients, minerals, all those things the plant's roots will absorb and it will transport it to all parts of the plants. So that all the parts of the plants will get sufficient amount of nutrients and it will grow very healthy and the proper growth will be there and development also will be there in that particular plant. Okay, and along with the water, minerals. So already I said that along with water, what are the things it is observing, remaining things? So what? Along with water, minerals and fertilizers are also observed. So along with water, what happens? Minerals and fertilizers also absorbed by the plant's roots. And plants contain nearly 90% of water. So plant contain how many percentage of water? Plant contains 90% of water. So first paragraph what we are discussing about what? So first one is water is very, very important thing. So all the living beings require water. So for what purpose it is required water? For proper growth and development. Okay. So how this water is absorbed by the plant's roots? So along with water, what are the remaining things it is absorbing? Along with the water, it is absorbing nutrients and fertilizers. And thus plants contain nearly how many percentage of water? Nearly 90% of water. Okay. And next one is water is essential because germination of seeds does not take place under dry condition. So water is very, very important. Why? And this germination of seeds does not occur. So this germination of seeds, words is very, very important. Germination of seed means what? The process of seeds developing into new plant. So germination of seeds means what? The process of developing seeds into new plant is nothing but germination of seeds. So water is very, very essential. This germination of seeds will not take place under dry condition. It requires water. Okay, and nutrients dissolved in water are transported to each part of the plant. Water is also protects the crop from both frost and hot air. Okay, so So nutrients dissolve in water. So already I said that what is water contains. When the plant's roots absorb water, it is not only water, that water, in that water what happened? Dissolved nutrients, minerals, manure, fertilizers, all those things will be there. Okay, so it will absorb by plant's roots and transport it to all parts of the plants. And next one, this water is protects from frost and hard air currents. So frost is nothing but covering of minute ice crystals on a cold surface. So frost is nothing but it is a minute ice crystals covering on the cold surface. Okay, and next one is hard air currents. So for that what happened? It requires sufficient amount of water. If it is a sufficient amount of water is there, so what happens? It can protect from those things. And to maintain the moisture of the soil for healthy crop growth, fields have to be watered regularly. So we must have to maintain moisture to the particular crop field. It requires moisture. So how we can able to maintain this moisture of the particular soil? By watering regularly. So we must have to water regularly to the particular crop field. Then only we can able to maintain the moisture of the soil. Okay. And next one, in this paragraph what we are discussing, we have discussed about what? Germination of seeds. So germination of seeds does not take place under dry condition. So it requires water. And along with water, what are the things it is absorbing? Along with water, it is absorbing nutrients also. So it is transported to all parts of the plants. And this water is preventing from frost and hard air currents. And we have to maintain the particular crop field moisture. So if you want to maintain crop field moisture, means what we must do? We must have to water at regular intervals. We must have to watering at regular intervals. Okay. And to the supply of water to crops at regular intervals. So the supply of water to crops at regular intervals is called what? Irrigation. And the time and frequency of irrigation varies from crop to crop, soil to soil, and season to season. So what happened? The supply of water varies from soil to soil, crop to crop, and season to season also. Some crops requires a lot of water, like rice. Okay, some crops requires less amount of water, and in according to season also, season to season also, the supply of water will be varying. For summer season, it requires a lot of water. In the case of rainy season, it requires less amount of water. Why it is required a lot of water in the summer season? Because summer season, the atmosphere is very high, the temperature will be very high. Not only the temperature, and humid also very less in the atmosphere. So what happens? Transpiration taking place. So transpiration is very high. So because of that reason, what happens in summer season, we have to supply more water to the particular crops. And what happens, this watering of the plants is differing from crop to crop, season to season. Okay, why it is season? Some plants requires a lot of water, some plants require less amount of water, and season to season also it requires. Okay, why is it so? Could it be due to the increased rate of evaporation of water from the soil and the leaves? So what happened in summer, the frequency of watering is higher. Why? Already I said that the temperature is very high. In the atmospheric temperature is very high. The humid is very less. Because of that reason, what happens in summer, the frequency of watering is higher. Okay, and next one is sources of irrigation. Next one is what? Sources of irrigation. What are the sources of irrigation? So what are the sources of irrigation means? The sources of water for irrigation are wells, tube wells, ponds, lakes, rivers, dams, and canals. What are the sources of irrigation? Ponds, lakes, rivers, wells, tube wells, canals, dams. These are the sources of irrigation. Okay, and next one is methods of irrigation. We have two methods of irrigation: traditional methods of irrigation and modern methods of irrigation. Okay, that first one is what? Traditional methods of irrigation. The water available in wells, lakes, and canal is lifted up by different methods in different regions for taking into the fields. So what happens? Already we have discussed about sources of irrigation: wells, tube wells, canals, dams. So what happens? The water available in wells and lakes or canals is lifted. We have to lift, right? So it is lifted by different methods in different regions, not only same methods. So they will be using different methods in different regions. Okay, cattle or human labor is So cattle or human labor is used in the methods. So these methods are cheaper. Cheaper means low in price. Cheaper means what? Low in price, but less efficient. Less efficient. Efficient means what? Producing good results. Less efficient means we will get less amount of results only. Less results only. Okay. The various traditional ways are. So what are the ways? What are the traditional ways? So first one is moat. So first one is moat, and second one is chain pump. Third one is Dekli, and fourth one is Rahat. So there are four methods of traditional irrigations. So what are those? First one is moat, chain pump, Dekli and Rahat. These are the four methods of traditional irrigations. So these methods are different regions, they are using different methods. So one region they may use one methods. For this method, what happened? They will be using cattle or human labor to lift the water lift the water. Okay, and pumps are commonly used for lifting water. So here what happens? Pumps are commonly used for lifting water nowadays. So for what we are using diesel to run the pumps? We want to put diesel, biogas, electricity and solar energy is used to run this pumps. So what are the things we are required to use to run the pumps? Diesel, biogas, electricity and solar energy. Okay, so this is nothing but traditional method of irrigation. Next one is modern method of irrigation. So in the modern method of irrigation, modern methods of irrigation help us to use water economically. So in the modern method of irrigation, what happens? It is help us to use the water economically. And the main methods are used as follows. So there are mainly two methods are this. One is sprinkler system, another one is drip system. So sprinkler system and drip system. Today we have discussed about irrigation and sources of irrigation and methods of irrigation. Okay, so in the methods of irrigation, we have two methods, traditional method and modern method. In the traditional method of irrigation, we have four methods, that is moat, chain pump, Dekli and Rahat. In the modern method, we have two types, that is sprinkler system and drip irrigation. In the next class, we are going to discuss about protection from weeds. Protection from weeds. Bye bye, children.